Good morning, everybody. A warm welcome to you all. This time it's a new webinar for the Access Optimizer version 3. My name is Roy Bent. I'm a community manager for Middle Europe. So let's get started. So what are we talking about today? Today we will be talking about the Access Optimizer version 3, which is a great new tool and a suite of plugins specially developed for Access Milestone X Protect, developed by Access. So first we are going to talk about what and why Access did develop this useful tool. We're going to look at the optimizer features. Of course, we are going to look at the requirements and compatibility and where to find all of the information required for the installation of these plugins and where to download it. So let's have a look at what and why Access did develop the Access Optimizer for X Protect. So what is it? Access X Protect Optimizer is actually a suite of plugins and tools specially designed to enhance the user experience with Milestone and Access cameras or Access devices in general. It offers maximum values to the end users and system integrators by delivering all the needed plugins for optimally running Access devices within X Protect. And at the same time, it helps unlock all the features and capabilities in both Access devices and in X Protect to bring the maximum value to our integrators, administrators, and operators. It also streamlines plugin management. Traditionally, system integrators and X Protect users needed to manually install the different plugins from Access, like the dewarping plugin or the temperature measurement for the 2901 thermal camera. But now we can install this all at once, and automatically the new functions and features will be deployed all across X Protect if it was in the smart client or in the management client. So this tool saves a considerable amount of time and efforts in search for download, install, and configuring all the relevant required plugins for Access devices. So why did we or why did Access develop this optimizer for X Protect? Well, we got feedback, especially Milestone and Access together got feedback from their partners in 2016. And partners expect Access and Milestone to be better integrated and work closer together. At the same time, it's also, of course, a challenge to keep up with all the developments from different camera vendors and Access, because they release so many new cameras and new devices with all these great new features that it's hard to keep up with. So once the new cameras or new devices are released with Access, they will be automatically integrated in the Optimizer suite as well. And that gives a great focus on deeper integration. And they do that because, yeah, Access, of course, distinguish themselves against competition, partly through innovation. So if you want to do or if you want to benefit from this innovation, the Optimizer plugin will, of course, put the innovation in hands of our users. And that's the biggest advantage of this plugin. So in January 2018, first version of the Access Optimizer for X Protect was released, and today it has over more than 10,000 installs, and it's highly appreciated by the integrators and Milestone users in general. So some of this feedback that we receive, one of the things, of course, that was mentioned, if you integrate, most of the time it's necessary to jump back and forth between an Access and a Milestone user interface, and that has been received as disrupted experience. So that's a big deal what is resolved with using the Access Optimizer. Functionality accessed outside of Milestone was perceived as useless because end users and customers usually don't have access to the web pages where they can find all these great features that Access has to offer. So if you integrate them into Milestone with the optimizer, then all these great new innovations that Access has developed will become available and will be available for the end users. And of course, integrators expect milestone and access to work closely together. So the Optimizer plugin is a good initiative and a great add-on to an ExpertX system. So in summary, access and milestone unique together. So this brings all the best what both companies has to offer. So it creates a superior user interface using access devices in the milestone ExpertX environment. Again, it puts the innovation into the hands of the milestone users. It brings substantial value for integrators, operators, and of course the administrators. And it's a gift that keeps on giving. So the Optimizer will continue to be developed, and as new devices will be launched by Access with new innovations, automatically they will become available to the Milestone VMS as well. So let's have a look at the features, because there's a ton of great features that are becoming available together with this Optimizer. So let's have a look at them one by one. And after that, we will have a closer look on each of these features in particular. So the first thing that is interesting, of course, that is the radar. And basically, we can divide the features that enhance the experience within Milestone into two categories. There's a category where we have plugins inside the ExpertX management client, so we call them ExpertX management client enhancements, and there's a part for the smart client where what we will call ExpertX smart client enhancements. So in the management client, there will be an option to configure radar, so there will be a radar plugin available if you install the optimizer for the management client, and it helps you to configure and manage access radar and set up the exclusion zones, set up the alarm sounds, etc., etc. In the latest version, in version 3, Access has added the speaker management. So now you can create zones, speaker zones, combine multiple speakers, synchronize them, playback clips, and use a push-to-talk feature from the smart client to address people inside a shop or in a restricted area, etc., etc. So this is a really, really great audio experience within ExpertX. Of course, from the beginning, from the get-go, when Access developed the optimizer, it had the camera assistant. And the camera assistant automatically lists all the cameras into a single overview, and you can edit the settings and configuration of all the Access devices within Milestone without having to jump back and forward into a Milestone or an Access web interface or using other configuration tools. No, everything can be configured straight from the ExpertX management client. Now let's have a look at the smart client enhancements, because there are lots of them. So there is a dewarping plugin for smooth dewarping in the client side and also live and recording. And of course, it will also be exported when you do a video export. You can also use the plugin in the export player from Milestone, so smart client player. There's on-screen controls. So all the Access cameras, or most of the Access cameras, are capable of providing specific camera features from the user interface. So if you want to do like focus or wiper on off, IR on off, it can be directly managed from the on-screen as an overlay. And this is also now available in the ExpertX smart client. And within the on-screen controls, one of the items is, of course, the speed dry to remove water from the PTC cameras. There's of course the wiper, Access spot temperature measurement for the thermal cameras. There is, and this is something outside the on-screen controls, there's the door station integration, of course, and other on-screen controls are autofocus, focus recall. And the optimizer tool in ExpertX also has an automatic update feature. So when there's a new update for the optimizer plugins, it will be possible to automatically download them and install them into the client you need. So you can install it from the management client, you can install it from the smart client as well. Also, with the latest version, version 3, Exeter released the license plate verifier integration into the smart client. So now you can manage and capture license plate and develop actions or rules, trigger rules inside Milestone from that. And that is a real great add-on for this. Last but not least, there's the PTC auto tracking version 2 that also becomes directly available in the Milestone smart clients, and it enables, disables, or it allows the operator to enable and disable PTC auto tracking for the supporting PTC cameras. So now let's have a look at the features one by one. So let's start with the Axis camera assistant. So what is it? It is the plugin inside the management client, and this embeds all the camera configuration inside the Milestone management client. So, and the great thing about this is that the user interface it loads, it's familiar with all the Axis users because it just loads the familiar camera configuration as you were configuring it from a web page. But now it's fully integrated into the management client. So what happens is, and that's the thing you should be able to see here. There's a list of cameras. So all the cameras that are being added into the Milestone recording servers will be listed here. So it contains the complete list of all the Axis cameras inside Milestone. And once you click on one of them, it automatically shows you the configuration for this camera without having to re-enter the password, because the password is already known by the system. So if you have clearance to use the management application or the management client, then of course you are also allowed to modify camera settings as well. This is really, really great. So if you are in a project and you need to configure 100 or 200 cameras, it's very easy to make camera adjustments, to run the camera applications, to stop the camera application, and even to configure the camera application as well. So all the ACAPs, the plugins inside the Axis cameras themselves, they can also be managed. And of course, you can dynamically search on device name, IP address, etc., etc. So this really saves a lot of time for the administrators and system integrators to manage their camera settings. Next feature, or maybe let's have a look at the details of the settings as well. Here you can see a screenshot, a zoom in on the camera settings. And of course, there's also a little demo here. So let's have a look at the demo. So when you open up this management client, the first thing you will notice is the list of cameras on the left-hand side. So I'll bring my highlight tool or my spotlight. So here is the list of Axis cameras. They are automatically populated for all the cameras added to a Milestone management server. You click on one of them and it automatically loads the user interface all Axis users are familiar with in configuring. In this case, the tab for the applications, the ACAP applications, has been selected, and now you also have the opportunity to enable to run or install different ACAP plugins inside the camera. So now you can start managing also that part of the camera as well. So continue with that. If you click on it, then it will automatically open up, of course, the application for in this case it is the Axis Video Motion Detector 4, and here you can set up the motion detection zones inside the camera without having to switch to a camera web interface. This is really convenient. So setting up, even an option to test, and if you have test configured the alarms inside Milestone, then you will automatically receive the alarms as well. Great tool, very useful, saves a lot of time. So I would recommend everybody to use this. The next thing is on-screen controls. So on-screen controls, and there are many of them. So let's have a look on what examples we can have with the on-screen controls. So for on-screen controls, a few examples for XProtect or the camera versions, firmware versions 7.10 and 7.40 and higher. So with the on-screen controls, you can, for example, turn on the wiper. You can turn on and off the heater, speed dry, infrared, focus recall, wide dynamic range, electronic shutter settings, and even run the autofocus, which is also very useful. In the lower right corner of each toolbar in a camera view in the XProtect Smart Client, if you click on this icon here, which is marked in the red circle, it will automatically open up the menu. And depending on what device you have selected or the device that you are viewing, it will automatically put available the different options for this camera. If it's a very sophisticated and very advanced camera with AR, electronic image stabilization, defog, things like that, you can turn them on and off or make settings for these functions directly from the user interface in the XProtect Smart Client. So you don't have to go back to the camera interface and turn wide dynamic range on and off. No, you can immediately adjust the image quality as you need it. So this brings great value to the operator, because if there's a lot of backlight suddenly from car lights or the sun is appearing inside the camera image, you can directly turn on wide dynamic range to create the best image possible to register all your incidents. Very, very useful for the operators. Of course, smart focus or autofocus in the smart client. Also an on-screen control feature. So again, click on the on-screen control button inside the right lower corner. So this icon, and then the menu pops up like this, and then you can hit the autofocus button. And the great thing is, this is not only for PTC cameras, it's also for fixed cameras that have an autofocus motor inside. So when the focus shifts during the night, sometimes you have that when the cameras turn from color to black and white, there's a chance that the focus will shift because of the IR. And at the same time, you can immediately, as an operator, readjust the focus so you have a clear view on your scene. Very, very useful as well. Here's how it looks like. So here's the on-screen controls button, and it will automatically then pop up the autofocus control. So let's have a look how that would work in real life. Right lower corner, click set focus, click autofocus, and immediately the camera will start focus and it will be sharp again. Really great. Q2901E spot temperature measurement. And there's more than only spot temperature measurement for this thermal camera. So what does it look like? We have used the on-screen controls button on the right lower corner, and when you click on it, when you have selected the Q2901, then it will automatically pop up with the temperature measurement in the right upper corner. And just by clicking in the image anywhere you want, it will automatically measure the temperature of that area. Also, what is possible with this is zone measurement. So you can measure temperature zones and display them, and you can create alarms with that. So if a temperature rises too high, then you can automatically have an alarm inside the management client or in the alarm manager for the smart client. And it will, of course, look something like this. So here's the demo. Optimizer, temperature control, and alarms. So again, push the on-screen control button, click on measure spot temperature. The spot temperature measurement window will appear, and just by clicking in the image, it will automatically show you the temperature. Above in the text overlay, there's the zone temperature measurement shown. So there's two zones defined in the image, in the middle and in the right upper corner, to measure the average temperature in this zone. And it's also shown in the upper left corner in the image as an overlay text. So these zones can be configured, of course, from the CAS system. Click anywhere in the or in the image to show the temperature, the actual temperature of that area. And of course, when a zone gets too hot, we can generate alarms for this. And then there's your temperature alarm together with the recordings and even a bookmark if necessary. So that's the spot temperature measurement for the Axis thermal camera. So the next thing, and this is a really, really great audio experience within Milestone together with the Axis door station. So let's have a look at the Axis door station. What does the door station provide the users inside XProtect? Well, there's a couple of things. It performs visitor management using call screening and door control functionality. It also provides call management, so you can accept, decline, hold, or even terminate a call, of course. There's door control management, so you can provide access, extend access for disabled people, and lock and unlock door. And of course, the door station integration will provide you with a log or slash a history with playback functionality, so you can actually see from the past who has entered and who accepted the call and who you were calling to, because you also have a visual verification who was in front of the door. So let's have a look at the incoming calls. So when somebody pushes the button on a door station, it will automatically pop up this pop-up message inside the XProtect Smart Client. It will always come in front. So no matter what you do on your workstation, you can always be notified when somebody hits the door station button. Then the operator can accept or decline the call or even provide access instantly if the person in front of the door is immediately recognized, of course. So you can accept, hold, or decline calls. You can provide access and extend door open time if you want. So when you're in the conversation, you have also a couple of options. You have, of course, the option to mute your microphone, again, the provide access button, or to end the call by pressing the hang up button. On top of that, there's an on-screen overlay. On the right upper corner for a door station, there's this green door symbol. It's a dynamic symbol, so it shows you in real time what the status of the door is, if it's open, if it's closed, or if there's or if it's locked, and then it will become red. So this is for the operator a very easy way to check door status for the door station. And in the toolbar, there's of course the option to access and extend access so to open the door. But there is also the call history. And when you press this call history button, then it will populate this menu where you can select all the incoming calls that have been received or been accepted. Or and you can also see in the second column if the door was really opened and access was provided, yes or no. So here's all the call logs. Selecting one of the call log lines, it will automatically show you the playback and the recorded footage for this interaction with this door and this person. So you can immediately verify if the operator has done a good job by letting people in or declining people from getting in. So this is really a nice integration and a good intercom integration. So yeah, I would recommend if you are using door station, just install the optimizer tool and these features will automatically become available in the smart client. Here's a small demo on how it works. So just press the button if you want to come in. The operator will receive the incoming call. You can accept the call, open the door, and let the people in. Very easy, very nice. Next, what is installed with the Optimizer suite is the Axis license plate verifier. And with the license plate verifier, you can, of course, like the name says, capture license plate, do license plate search, or trigger events and rules and alarms inside XProtect. The license plate verifier also comes as a kit with the P1455 LPV. And then once this camera is added to the milestone system and the plugin or the optimizer tool has been installed, you will automatically have the ability to search and monitor all the license plates that are captured by this camera. Of course, the license plate verifier also comes as a separate ACAP, but of course the P1455 is specially developed to work together with this application. So this is the really the best combination for using license plate verification tools like this. So once the optimizer is installed, the camera has been added, you can go to the smart client into the settings menu of the smart client, and there you can enable for each smart client where you want to receive the license plates. You can just enable it in the menu, in the settings menu, and at that moment when you enable it, the smart client will have an additional tab where all the license plate captures are being shown. So everything that has been captured will be listed here for a certain amount of retention time, which you of course can specify separately. And then you can click on each image or in each line and review the license plates and categorize them. So you can create a whitelist, blacklist, etc., etc. And you can of course search for license plates and the associated recordings with that. So this is a very easy way of adding license plate verification and actions and rules into a milestone system without setting up a separate license plate server, additional server hardware. No, this is a very easy, smooth way to integrate license plate registration into XProtect by just putting the camera there, loading the ACAP, which can be, of course, loaded from the camera assistant inside the management client, and then you can automatically use license plate verification in a smart client. Next up, PTC Auto Tracking version 2. So there's a couple of cameras, of course, supporting auto tracking with Axis, especially the Q6075 PTC dome that has support for auto tracking 2. And once you enabled metadata in the milestone management client, then you can automatically switch on and off the auto tracking from the smart client. And this is very useful because sometimes when auto tracking is not really tracking the right persons, you can immediately stop the auto tracking from the user interface. So not having to switch again back to, again, a web interface or something else. And this, of course, makes life for the operator a lot easier. So either it works perfectly and it tracks the right people, so you don't have to do anything as an operator, or you can just pause the auto tracking from the smart client. This feature is supported in XProtect 2017 R3 or higher, and of course you at least have to have one of our Plus products or the XProtect Expert or Corporate, which we call our C code products. This is how it looks like from the configuration. So in the recording server, you have to go to the metadata stream, enable event metadata and set it to yes. And of course, in the camera, you can go to the camera assistant, select the P6555 in this case, and set the auto tracking to on. And then that moment, when you load the camera inside the smart client with the on-screen controls button, you have there the ability to turn on and off the auto tracking. And what also is nice is that it also has this overlay in the right upper corner of the camera view, where you can see what the actual status is of the auto tracking, on, off, and really active at the moment. At the same time, of course, you can also, with the camera system, set up the detection zones on where the auto tracking should be triggering. So in this case, there's a yellow region of interest drawn inside the image over here, and as soon as objects or individuals appear inside this region of interest, then of course the auto tracking automatically zooms in and starts tracking the object or person or individual inside this this region of interest, and of course outside of the region of interest, and keeps on tracking until it leaves the image. Again, this is very useful for the operator, and it keeps focusing on real incidents as they appear. Are the tracking on and off, and the actual live status. In Optimizer version 2, in an earlier version of Optimizer, we have integrated dynamic event integration, and this is an integration that has been done at the driver level. So once the cameras are added to the system, we can now dynamically handle events that become available from the Axis ACAP modules or plugins. So we call that dynamic device event handling. It has been released from ExpertTech 2018 R3 together with device pack 9.9. So if you have these as minimum requirements, then the cameras you add from Axis supporting ACAP, Axis camera application platform, events that become available from these ACAP modules will automatically become available inside the ExpertTech management client, so you can trigger events and rules and alarms with that. So how does that look like? Once the ACAP is installed, of course, through the camera system, for instance, then you open up the events tab inside the management client for this particular camera. And there you can see the added events for this specific application module inside the camera. In this case, the Axis Guard Suite is installed inside the camera, inside the ACAP. And automatically you will see, and you don't have to do anything for this, it's just a part of the integration. And that's why it's so nice. You automatically have the configured events available from Defense Guard, the Motion Guard, and these are dynamically added into the milestone system, so you can directly use them once you've installed the Guard Suite inside the camera. And now you can trigger events, you can trigger rules within milestone, you can generate alarms from them, so you don't have to do special configurations to have Guard Suite events inside milestone or any other ACAP events inside milestone. Here's also an example for the CityLock ACAP. In this case, we have also defined the alarms from the CityLock ACAP, so you can directly generate or configure the alarms as well. In version 3, the latest version, which is available since a couple of weeks now, Axis has really, really done a great job in integrating their audio inside milestone, and the audio integration gets only better and better and better in the couple of years to come. But let's have a look on where we at right now. We call that speaker manager, or Axis calls that speaker manager, and with this you can manage all the audio devices from Axis when they are integrated into the ExpertTech. So a lot of Axis devices are equipped with audio features that require traditional plugins to run optimally in ExpertTech, but now we have the Optimizer suite, and now you can manage all these devices from the management client. And what can we actually do? So we can play back the clips, we can make announcements, we can configure the speakers, we can set up the zones, speaker zones, so we can combine multiple speakers, and we even can synchronize them, so there's no lag and delay between one or two or maybe three speakers when you try to play back audio clips together on multiple speakers. So this is really, really great. So how does it look like? Zone management, push to talk, play pre-recorded clips. So let's have a look how that looks like. So like I said before, we have one of these things is the camera assistant, which becomes available inside the management client, of course. And now we have Axis speaker management over here. So all the audio devices and all the audio inputs and outputs that have been added inside the recording server and have been grouped in the devices section and in speaker groups, these speaker groups will automatically become available over here. So this is a direct representation of the speaker groups defined in XProtect. And once that is done, the speaker management will show automatically the groups and the speakers associated with these groups. So in this case, we have, of course, the most important thing, the speaker management. And now we can start associating audio clips, associating cameras with the speaker groups, and add and remove clips as you like to an entire group or zone. And of course, you can synchronize them as well. This is how it looks like from a user interface inside the smart client, because there's also a ton of options there that an operator can use. In playback and live, you have on the left side a MIP plugin section, of course, in the MIPS plugin pane, as we call it. And there you can find and search for speakers or speaker groups. See the microphone level that is connected to the smart client. And there you can play also the media clips. So you can either play back a pre-recorded clip or a clip that has been added to a speaker group, or you can directly push the talk to an entire speaker group. Very, very useful for the operator, of course. In the alarm manager, there's also audio integration. So the alarms that have been associated, and if the camera has an associated speaker with it, you can also respond to an alarm with audio. So if you see an alarm coming in and you see something happening that is not appropriate, then you can automatically play back an alarm clip or a notification message to that area where this incident happens. So you can respond immediately as an operator. And it automatically selects, of course, the right speaker group. And if it doesn't, or if you want to address other zones as well, then you can just easily select it from the drop-down menu, or you just click on Find Speakers and you type the speaker name that you are looking for. Immediately response, of course. And also in the camera view toolbar in the right lower corner, you can see this small microphone symbol there. And once you click on it, it opens up the camera or the speaker menu. And there again, you can see the microphone level of your smart client, and you can play back pre-recorded clips, and you can, of course, push to talk. In this case, you can also see there's a speaker zone attached to this camera, associated to this camera, or, of course, an individual speaker. So you can select as an operator, or you can choose as an operator between one or multiple speakers or speaker groups. What else can we do with speaker management? So we can create logical speaker groups. We can put speakers into a standalone mode. We can create zones of speakers. We can synchronize them so there is no audio delay. We can put speakers in a leader slash follower mode. We can associate cameras to a speaker group. And of course, when there's a speaker group, we can, of course, control the master volume. And here's a detailed snapshot. One important tool, of course, also of speaker management is the audio clip management. So in this case, you can now select one of the speaker groups. It will automatically open up the audio clips available. And these audio clips can be imported inside the smart client. So there's a directory on the smart client PC where you can put all your MP3 files, and once they are in this specific directory, then they will automatically be shown in the audio clip management. And then you can, by adding or clicking on the plus sign, you can add the clip to the speakers or the speaker group, or you can remove them from the speaker group by clicking on the minus. So here's an example on how to add and remove speakers. So you go to the speaker group. There you can see three pre-configured speaker groups already. You can edit the device group members by right-clicking on it. Then you go to the recording server. There's the list of all the speakers that have been added to XProtect. Select one, click on add, and then it's added. If you want to remove, you could do the same basically, and you select the camera and click remove. Easy as that. If you right click the speakers, then you can also create a new speaker group. So now there is being added a fourth folder. And in this folder, you can then add the individual speakers you require in this group. And once you've done this, the groups will automatically be available in the speaker management. So that's how easy it can be. And this is how easy and how powerful the Access Optimizer is for XProtect. Now, of course, there are some requirements and compatibility things we have to note. So let's have a look at that, requirements and compatibility. So what is required? Most plugins in Access Optimizer for Milestone XProtect are compatible with XProtect Corporate and Expert from XProtect 2016 R1 and higher, but it varies a little bit because some features are not available. Access Optimizer is fully supported with the latest clients on the following platforms. So Express Plus, Professional Plus, Expert and Corporate, all our C code products. And these platforms here below, Essential Plus, Express and the Professional Editions, only support the dewarping functionality. So Essential Plus, our E-code Express and E-code Professional, they only have the dewarping functionality. So please keep that in mind when you are offering this into a project, that it's recommended actually to use one of our C-code products, Express Plus, Professional Plus, Expert or Corporate. If you are inside the management client or in the smart client, there's this option to actually show compatibility. So if you go to the settings menu of a smart client, you can see a blue link which says show compatibility info. And when you click on it, it will automatically open up the compatibility information for all the different versions and all the features that are inside Optimizer and which milestone version you actually need to have this supported in your system. This is a great overview. So please check this before you try to make a promise to a customer. In the settings menu over here, you also see the update button. So if the update is not pushed automatically because you don't have an internet connection, you can just maybe provide temporary internet connection to your server or your client. And then you can hit the update button and it'll automatically download the latest version of the optimizer for XProtect and then installs it directly. Very convenient. So where can we find all this greatness? So there's two things you can do, of course. I think the most important thing is our Milestone Marketplace. Milestone Marketplace is our webpage where we put the information for all our plugins, all our integrations from our technology partners. And of course, Access Optimizer is there as well. There's a short description. You can get in touch with Access if you need. You can download the manuals there. You can download the plugin. And of course, if you want to download the plugin, please make sure you have an Access and My Access login credentials available so you are able to download it. Where can we find the Milestone Marketplace? It's on www.milestonesys.com/community/marketplace. And you can add start exploring. And there's the search option where you can type in optimizer for XProtect. And then it will automatically get you to the right place. Of course, you can also go directly to the Access website, Access in the software options. There you can just find the optimizer, or you can just go to the search bar in the Access website and just type optimizer for XProtect, and it will automatically show you where to download it. It's really easy. So this was it regarding the Access Optimizer for XProtect. I hope you've enjoyed it and see you next time. Thank you very much.